Hi everybody! Today I'm going to talk about how I got my tracks recorded for my Heavy Machinery cover. Before I start, I want to address two things. First, in case you're wondering, I decided to make a second behind the scenes early after my first one because I experimented a lot more when recording this cover. Second, my friend Robin complained about the fact that I could have explained more in my first behind the scenes video because of what he's not familiar with. Here's the thing. If you're new to audio productions and want me to explain more, then I will have to make separate videos for that. I want my usual videos on this channel to be as simple and straightforward as possible, especially for the more experienced guys. Anyways, here's how I recorded my tracks. The samples I used for my drum tracks were not exactly for my BK5 this time, but believe it or not, they were my own samples. Yes, you heard me correctly. I managed to record my own samples after tracking live drums for a cover song I worked on back in college. But I'm still not satisfied, and I don't think I'll ever be satisfied with samples. By the way, shout out to Nick Gilroy for letting me borrow his kit. Bass guitar was my BT50 mic'd with an Audix D6 and SM57. The D6 was for lows and highs, while the 57 was for mids. Then, I took my DI track, reamped it with my Radial Pro RMP reamp box, turned on the distortion mode on my BT50, and recorded the distorted signal with the same mics. I blended the clean and slightly compressed D6 track with a distorted 57 track, and that's how I got my bass tone. For guitars, I used my Marshall amp and typical pedal chain again, but for rhythm guitars, I recorded two tracks with my guitar amp, then three tracks with my bass amp set to distortion, and blended the two different guitar tones. The amps were still mic'd with my 57 and D6 combination. When it comes to keyboards, I decided to use that same recording technique I used when tracking synth strings for that same cover song I recorded live drums for in college. The signal was not only recorded via DI, but also through a Hi-Z input. The DI track was dry, while the Hi-Z one was wet. The effects on the wet signal came from my Behringer VAMP 2, slight distortion, but heavy on modulation. I then mixed the dry and wet tracks to taste and didn't have to do much in terms of post-processing in the mix. And there you go, that was how I got my tracks recorded for my Heavy Machinery cover. If you want me to go into more detail on some things, let me know. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned for more content.